Today's the final presentation for the MM3305 3D Printing and Additive Manufacturing class. We call it Businesses for the Third Industrial Revolution because we believe that 3D printers are going to bring an entirely new way of creating things to our society.
We gave them the freedom and the skills needed to teach us something about 3D printing. And the result was this event. We had students printing medical devices, we had students creating their own filament, and we had students creating companies based on what could be done with 3D printing, you know, that would be difficult to do any other manufacturing method.
So we decided to create a brace for people that have rheumatoid arthritis.
We can actually look at real world problems, actually do a little bit of researching in a class, and actually work with a team, and we used all of our strengths to come up with a product.
The funny thing is, we're from three different countries, we study three totally different things, and we never met each other before this, but we really like coffee.
We were like, whoa, let's see if we can make a coffee cup out of coffee and 3D printing coffee.
The most important part of the entire course was watching these students from so many different disciplines. I mean, we had students from Denmark, from Taiwan, from Brazil.
So I was able to develop a lot of my creativity working with people from different places and with different ideas.
We had students with backgrounds in engineering, chemical engineering, mechanical, industrial and systems engineering, business, design, all these different backgrounds. And being able to watch them actually come to a conclusion and get to work with people that are from entirely different countries, entirely different backgrounds, was the most rewarding thing for me.
Another really unique aspect of this class is that not only are we teaching these students everything they need to know to 3D print a part, but we also give them real world examples of how to experience 3D printing. So we brought them to Stratasys, which was the world leader in 3D printing, and let them see what's possible with some of the biggest and best machines in the world. We've also taken them to Worrell product design firm and gotten to see how a customer is actually using it in the commercial space.
I knew a bit about 3D printing before, but I feel like I know so much. I almost, you know, could go out to a company and be like, hey, I know this.
We're going to give you the tools, and then we want you to do what you're passionate about, because we know that that's the best work that you're going to give us.
I think people can see like that we really believe in the product, because they see like in your eyes and in your posture, in the way that you behave, that you really believe in that.
And being able to feed that fire of innovation and just creativity, and then being able to manufacture that just next day, has been just a joy to teach.
Being able to design something in SolidWorks and being able for it to come to fruition, get a prototype and maybe an end-use product, and we're able to do that on many different levels for this course.
Today, things are changing. Humans are getting smarter, we're getting better with software, it's getting cheaper. We can do things now that were impossible 5 years ago, and our students are doing it, and they're pushing the limits.
And that's really what's happening. What happened to computation and communication through this device and through many others like it is about to happen in the world of fabrication, and it's just exciting to be able to be on the brink of it here in Minneapolis.